behind the scene of our fasting, when you are fasting, make sure you rest. Make sure you rest very well. Listen to the word of God and listen to things that will edify you. So I'm resting. Today is the last day of our fasting. And it's been wonderful. It's been awesome. God did what only Him can do. So I'm going to put you through the activities of the last day of my fasting. You know, it's so exciting, you know, waiting upon the Lord for 21 days. And it's so wonderful. I'm really looking for the day that the Lord will tell us to wait for 40 days. But these 21 days, as you know, is prophetical. For 21 days, Daniel fasted. And on the last day, and I tell you that in the morning session, it was powerful. It was powerful, like powerful. And I had to go somewhere this in the morning. So literally, I had about, how many hours sleep? About 3 hours. I don't think it goes up to 3 hours. I'm really tired, but I think I have to do other things because before we break our fast. So I'm going to go and do some cooking. Come along with me. See you soon.
All right, we're back. Welcome to my kitchen. Welcome, welcome, welcome. So this afternoon, I'm going to be cooking. You know, the strange thing is when we're fasting, whenever I want to cook, I always invite the Holy Spirit. I'll say, Holy Spirit, I'm fasting and I don't want to taste this food. And you know what? It tells me exactly the sauce, how much pepper, and all that I should put. So because today is our last day of the fasting, and I really like to, when we go for the communion and all of those things, because we're going to have communion for the last day, we're going to be praising Jehovah, you know. So we're going to be having communion. So I just want to, after the communion, just to rest. You know, it's very, very key. It's very important for us as children of God to always rest. Especially when you're in the ministry, because ministry, it's hard work, you know. You work hard. You need to work hard. But then, you need to create time for yourself and rest. It's very key. So I'm going to be cooking. I'll try my best to cook. I went shopping today. I bought some yam. I love yam, but not that bad like that. But I know in this area, you hardly get... You get it, but it's a bit expensive. It's quite expensive. So, I bought some to cook another day. Sometimes you run out of idea. I don't know whether it happens to you. I run out of idea what to cook and what to eat and all of that. I just went to buy some meat and all that, you know. Since the fasting, most times I don't eat much. Like, even when we break the fast, you don't really have much appetite. So this cooking I'm doing is actually for my family, because I don't really have, I've lost appetite of what to eat. You know, like, what do you want to cook? What am I even cooking? You know, sometimes you have no idea. So but food has to be at home. And it's always cheaper when you are somebody that cooks. It's always very cheap. So you're welcome. So in this, on our YouTube channel, we're going to be doing a lot of vlogging and teaching and the word of God, the practical things. To, as a child of God, Christianity is not boring. No. Christianity is, as a child of God, is not boring. And people look at it and say, oh, I'm going to lose these, all of those things. Look, my brother, my sisters. Christianity is the best. Serving God and having Christ in your life is the best. So come along with me. I'm going to put you through what I'm going to cook. And I have no idea yet. But what I'm doing is I'm going to cook some meat. I've already done the pepper. You need to plan. So I've already done the pepper. And I've already... So I'm going to fry some meat and cook some stew. And then I'll look at the soup and see what I'll cook. And then one day I'm going to be putting you through this evangelist life as a child of God. My lifestyle as a child of God, you find out that is actually the best and so sweet. And then sometimes you look at what I eat and all that. That, why am I always shining? I eat a lot if I'm not fasting, but when I'm fasting, I'm fasting. So come along, I'll show you what I'm going to be cooking today. And then when I finish cooking, I'll show you how it is. I'm not going to taste it because the Holy Spirit is my taster. So I just tell him, Holy Spirit, how many soup, how many Maggi, how many sauce? And he will tell me. So come along with me. Come.
So everything is finished now. We finished the cleaning. Everything, I finished cleaning. Food is ready. See? Everything, my egusi soup. I don't know whether you can see it. Let's see. Let me see whether I can actually show you. Let's see. It's not showing. Why? Okay, yeah. This is my egusi soup. Yeah. So, yeah, that's it. So, you use wisdom. And this is my stew. It's still steaming. You use wisdom in everything. So, now I'm going to prepare for breaking of our fast for 21 days. Whatever has a beginning must have an end, you know. So, I'm going to go now, change, and prepare for our fasting, at the break of our fast. So I bless the name of the Lord for everyone that connected, you know, for the grace and the testimonies that only God did. The Lord moved mightily during this fasting. I tell you the truth. The Lord moved very, in fact, from the beginning we started, everybody has a testimony, you know, like God just did mighty things, mighty, mighty things among us. And we thank God, you know. I thank God that for everyone that connected, God heard our cry. And our lives can never remain the same. Because when you wait upon the Lord in the place of fasting, you know, you trust in Him, the Father, I know you are able to make the impossibility possible. God will surely answer. And as we start this new year with, you know, with the Lord Almighty, He's definitely going to be with us and help us in the name of Jesus. So now, I need to go and change and prepare for our breaking of the fast. So this is my daily activity. This was how I planned. I did my day. It just had to do with planning. When you plan yourself very well, you plan your life, you know, you plan it, you won't be frustrated. And this is just to show you that Evangelist too has things, you know, like there are things that you can do while you're doing things for God. You can plan yourself. And Christianity is very sweet, you know, like, it's really, really sweet. I'm telling you, it's actually the best thing to do in life, to give your life to Jesus, surrender all to Him, and He will lead you and direct you. So I'll see you in another video. Have a wonderful day. I wish I could give you my soup to taste, but I won't be able to do that. So go and try the food, my recipe, and get back and tell me did you enjoy it? I'm going to enjoy mine. I'll definitely enjoy my, definitely. So I'll finish our rest. And we're back again for Command in the Morning on Monday. So make sure you subscribe to the channel. Follow us on Facebook, Foundation on the Soil Rock Ministry, Matthew 7 verse 25. And I know that as you do that, your life will never remain the same. Shalom.